Hey guys, what's up, and welcome back to another video of the pawn. We recently destroyed Rippers.
Okay,
not actually destroyed them, but you know. So I'll be riding with this lady. We have to get back the power to
long story.
We have to return the power to Lost Lake.
I was a member of the 10th Mountain, part of a forward unit working with the Northern Alliance.
Shit, I didn't know you were in the army.
You want to hear this or not?
Sorry.
We were advancing on Mazar-e Sharif. We got ambushed by a group of Taliban heading the other way. And they were in flatbed trucks decked out with ZU-23s, modified anti-aircraft guns.
Big guns.
Yeah, really big fucking guns. Our Humvee exploded, went over a cliff, right into the Hari. You know how hard it is to drown in Afghanistan? It's hard. The place is one giant goddamn desert. Anyway, I was thrown clear. When I came to, the Humvee was upside down in the river. I swam out to see if anyone survived. I pulled a body back to shore. And I did that seven more times. By the time I pulled in Tanner, my Sarge, I was done. And when I came home, I don't know, I bought a bike, spent a couple of years on the road, just moving from place to place.
Oh,
and,
sorry.
To farewell, you come around here, right?
Yeah. Okay, so by the time I finally settled down, I got a job at a bike shop run by this old guy named Jack.
And, Jack.
He ran the club. The press, that's what we used to call him. He patched me in himself.
Wait, Jack. I remember who you were talking about. He was in prison or something.
Some bad shit went down, and he ended up taking the rap for the club.
Sounds like you guys were pretty tight.
Where are we going? Oh my god. Where the hell did we come from? I don't know, man. Wherever we came from, leave it. Here it is. We came from here.
Oh, shit. There had to be one, right?
Let's come back in the morning. You can get whatever tools you need, and we'll finish it up then. There'll be fewer freaks out.
So no hot shower tonight? Okay. But I want to show you something first.
Ricky, it's been a long day.
Come on, you know a lot about the freaks. I just want to show you something you might not know. Come on, we're out here anyway.
Shit, okay.
Let's go.
Can I ask you something?
God, like I said before, could I stop you?
Why are you still flying colors?
I don't know what you mean.
I mean, why do you still wear the cuts? You and Boozer, it's not like you're trying to recruit anymore or staking out territory.
No.
A couple of guys I worked with at the plant wore colors on the weekend. I asked them about it once. They said they wore them as a way of saying, fuck you, to, I don't know, the cops, authority, the government. So what are you rebelling against?
Whatever's left. Look, we wear them because we wear them. What do you want? I mean, no idea about Boozer, but I ain't trying to say shit. It's just, cut? That's who I am. I've done a lot of stupid shit in my life. But joining the MC, well, let's just say that it's one of you think.
Ricky, what are we doing here? I've seen the Nero death trains before and the boards.
I know. Not like this. Watch.
There are so many of them.
Come on, move. Sometimes to see them. They stay in those old machine buildings and they come out every night like someone's ringing a dinner bell, right? When it's morning, they go back inside and what? Hibernate?
You mean they're the dinosaurs?
Uh-huh. No. One time I got way too close and a dozen of them started chasing me. It's like poking a hornet's nest. Come on, let's get out of here. It's getting dark.
Hey, where the hell have you been all day?
Yeah.
Nice to see you too.
Yeah, well, Schizo said you and Deacon took off.
I'm tired, okay?
Oh, that's right.
Hey, Deacon. Thank you.
Yeah, well, just let me know when you're ready to tackle that transformer. I'll be around.
Sure.
Bullshit.
What is your problem?
No. What is your problem?
I just said I'm tired. That's it.
Okay, I'm sorry. Like I said, I was worried. It's not like you to just take off without talking to me.
Okay.
So that's it?